was a genuine, tremendous excitement, more excitement than I've ever witnessed.
There's a buzz in the city. You felt it, you know, Shaq's in town. And
in this city, I've never been the same. It's not only in arena, it's restaurants, you know, it's nightclubs, it's wherever, because Shaquille O'Neal was in Miami.
Say hello, Miami!
The guy's larger than life. People are attracted to him. People like him. He brings that aura.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shaquille O'Neal!
Shaquille O'Neal, like no other.
Like no other. It's a good title.
Neal's back in on Eli, no double yet. Takes it to the baseline. Oh, oh baby! Shaquille O'Neal rocking the house.
When he gets a spot on the block, I mean, you're pretty much dead.
That's 340 pounds moving like that. You know, when he hits you, the defender, he's going to feel it after the game.
Darius Miles takes a seat on the defense from the Diesel.
Oh, I think he changed the game a lot because of his size.
On the drive, great defense by O'Neal. Daddy's home.
It's been like this since day one, and it's always going to be Shaq.
Tayshaun's shot rejected by Shaq.
He still has the most presence and is the most intimidating force in our league.
There's just no one that physically can even come close to challenging him.
He's a massive player with massive skills, man. And, you know, he dominates a game like no other.
Get out of here with that stuff. Who do you think you are?
You know him simply as Shaq.
They love him. He's a comedian.
Shaquille O'Neal like no other. He's an electrifying player. He's a bigger-than-life personality.
He's a fun-loving guy. He's warm-hearted, and he's very silly.
Whoa!
Dominant, elbow throwing, dunking, everything.
I mean, he has nothing else to prove in this game.
Rookie of the Year award.
NBA MVP. A three-peat and a sweep.
The reason he's still playing, because he want to win another championship.
Uploaded to Shaq. Bradley is there.
He wants to reach that pinnacle as the most dominant player to ever play the game.
O'Neal, that is power personified.
I'm Shaquille O'Neal, like no other. You like that, don't you? You like that one, don't you? You like that one, don't you?
Throughout his career, he has been an overpowering force. And at times, Shaquille O'Neal seems almost superhuman.
The more you whine, the more bigger I get. And the more bigger I get strong. And the more stronger I get, nobody can stop me.
What it comes down to is stopping one man, the most physically dominant center, maybe the most physically dominant player ever to play in this game.
What do you do with the big fella, Chip?
Nothing. Nothing you can do with him. They cannot stop 34.
Just too big. Just too strong.
Just too good.
On the cutter. Wait. Lobs it.
Oh! Shaq!
O'Neal unleashes beautifully.
It's been like this since day one, and it's always going to be Shaq. And when you see the big fella in the middle, you know, you're going to think twice about going into the lane because he's a huge presence, and you have to formulate your whole game plan around playing him.
Shaq's the most dominant player in the game. I mean, he just does things that no one else can do just because he's physically that much more gifted or blessed or whatever you want to call it than everyone else. And he's a phenomenal force down the block.
O'Neal, two teams.
Well, he's a power center. You know, he's not a finesse center. He's not Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, or he's not Tim Duncan. He's the most powerful center probably in the history of the game, ever.
Jack spins. Oh, the extra move, he dumped it. Goodness. And he knocked David down.
And a rebound covered up by Shaq, who has no regard for human life inside.
That was a mad dunk there.
You know, it's almost impossible to guard him one-on-one. And you have to send, you know, two or three guys out just to stop him.
playing against him in practice every day, you see that, and you see how hard it is to guard him, and it makes you feel sorry for the other team.
Shoots the two. Oh, and Shaquille O'Neal with the stuff over Andrew Bynum.
Is Wilt Chamberlain reincarnated?
Wilt Chamberneezy. That's my alter ego.
You know, he changed the game, and he made a lot of teams, you know, start doing a lot of things differently. You know, teams in the Western Conference, everything they planned was around trying to figure out how to play against Shaq. And I don't know if there's ever been a guy in the history of the league that forced everybody in the NBA to try and figure out, okay, what can we do to match up against this guy?
Swatted away by Shaquille O'Neal. Shaq running the ball. Slam dunk Shaquille O'Neal.
He's been the best center and a dominant center since he came in the league. His strength combined with his quickness and talent is just amazing. It's exciting to play against him because you want to play against the best, but it also can be a health hazard. Got to be careful.
Coaches would say, okay. It would bring guys off the injured list with six fouls. And he'd have to take on four or five guys a night. And you know what? He did.
No human alive playing basketball can stop that man.
Shaq spins. Oh, the extra move! He dunked it!
I've been getting criticized ever since. A newborn, he's not going to fit those Pampers. His boom boom is too big. I have a boom 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 game. I always go to the first boom. If you take that away, then I hit you with the other boom. And then by that time, I put the big boom boom on and you'll be under the basket and it's a dunk. So, you know, there's not too many people that could withstand my boom boom.
He's just physically impossible to defend. That tremendous size with great footwork and great quickness. He's impossible to defend one-on-one. He's virtually impossible to defend with your team because he's also an extremely unselfish guy.
Nice pass by Shaq. Wade with a vicious right-handed stuff.
How did Shaq see him? He had eyes behind his head that time.
He's remarkably unselfish, and I think he enjoys making others around him better.
This is a true story. You may not believe it or not. I'm sleeping in my dorm room at LSU in Baton Rouge, and somebody puts their hand on my chest, and I can tell it's an older gentleman. He goes, Shaquille? And I look up, and it's a Wizard of Westwood. John Wooden, he's there with Dale Brown. He's just come to talk to you and I'm gonna tell you the same thing I told Bill Walton and Lou Alcindor. The true definition of a great player is how you make your players around you better. That's the true definition of a great player.
Well, that's one thing that I didn't know about him when he first got here is that he could pass. He can pass the ball tremendously.
Wait, comes back to her.
He was one of the greatest guys to play with because not only did he do the things he was capable of doing, but, you know, the sign of and the mark of a great player is, you know, how much better he makes his teammates. And I think he's one of the all-time greats at allowing the guys around him to flourish and still be very talented as well.
I am of the people. I'm not like your regular superstar. I'm just a guy who's considered a superstar, but not really a superstar. No bodyguards, no entourage, just plain old me. Shaquille O'Neal, like no other. People here are great. People here are very friendly, very hospitable. It's a great place to be, baby. Welcome to Miami.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
He's always been the big man on campus while remaining down to earth. Shaq can relate to everyone he meets.
Hello.
Even when he conceals his identity.
Let's see how many people notice me. I got my disguise on.
And looks certainly can be deceiving. Shaq's size makes him seem like an imposing figure until you actually get to meet him.
Normally when you see somebody that big, I mean, normally you like be afraid or scared or you don't want to talk. You know, whenever Shaq sees somebody, you know, he goes out his way to make them feel comfortable.
I come from Paris.
Paris, c'est bon.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
It seems like it can take all day for Shaq to walk a single block.
How you doing?
But he revels in the role of everybody's best friend.
He He's warm-hearted, and he's very silly. So when somebody see a guy that big and that masculine, be silly like them or sillier than them, it just makes them easier to love a guy like that.
You need help?
What?
Yeah, let me walk the dog. Thank you. Whose dog? Your dogs?
Yeah, my dogs.
What, all of them?
Yep.
With a size 22 shoe, Shaq's dogs may be even bigger than these, and he's never been one to resist a good photo op. Shaquille was comfortable in front of the cameras from the day he was drafted number one by the Magic in 1992.
I have a beautiful smile, see?
Congratulations. But it was his play that truly captured the fans' attention. He was a revelation, an enormous center playing with the reckless abandon of a guard and the joy of a kid who just loved the game. He combined his ferocity on the court with a fun-loving personality. It seemed that Shaq was a born entertainer.
This is how I've always been, and I've been this way ever since age zero.
Now you know I'm a professional rapper.
My main man Shaq got a funky black Benz.
Yeah, but Shaq geeks a lot of millions.
Oh my.
And he enjoyed getting close to his fans, even when some might be a little too close.
You ready? Bounce. Thank you.
You don't need anything?
No, I'm good.
Sure?
Yeah.
All right.
Back in Miami, Shaq's still working on his disguise.
My name is Steve. Nice to see you.
All right. Freaking out.
But when you're larger than life, it can be tough to hide.
Let me say you something, man. My name is Shaquille O'Neal. I'm the third brother of Shaquille O'Neal from the Los Angeles Lakers.
Y'all don't know nobody like me. Off the court, silly, extroverted.
Right now, we're in the locker room, and I'm going to look at my boys' gators. Last time I touched them, they bit me. Let's see what they do this time.
Get your gators!
But on the court, dominant, elbow throwing, dunking, everything.
Shaq usually crushes the competition, and he has a way of turning it all into one big joyride.
Me.
Winning a championship, take everything you got.
Yeah.
Sacramento, they thought it was a year. But I'm telling you, it's not. Vladdy said if we don't have home court advantage, we won't win.
What?
Vladdy, are you stupid? I'll tell you time again. You need to go when they know your name. It's the Lakers, we know how to play the game. You said that we would win at your place. Guess what? Kobe dunked it in your face. You need to go where people know your name. Hello. Is it me you're looking for? And I wonder what you say. And I wonder what you do.
While he's had plenty to sing about during his career, he often saves his best performances for the holidays.
It was the first day of Christmas, my true love said to me, 5 golden rings.
I do have a favorite Christmas song, but I don't know the words.
4 something something 3, something something 2,
something something.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
That's the only word I know to the song.
Merry Christmas to you.
And if you've never seen a 7'1", 330-pound child, this is what he looks like. From the moment he first descended on the NBA, the world's biggest kid has made fans everywhere. And now he's taken his act to a new playground. The Shaq attraction has arrived in Miami, the latest hotspot for him to strut his stuff. But through new teams and new towns, the more things change for Shaq, the more they remain the same.
What's up, baby? You need to go where people know your name. Dun, 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 dun. I don't know the rest of the words, but I live where everybody knows my name.
The song may not be as fresh, but his effect on people is.
All right. Happy Thanksgiving.
And it's clear that basketball is just part of the big man's world.
We have definitely been blessed. And somehow he found his way down here to Miami with the most talented, most dominant player in the world. And I want to welcome Shaquille O'Neal.
He has a sense of humor and also, I think, a great perspective about where his life is in terms of professional basketball and his corporate life and all those other things. So he's got a lot on his plate.
Any center in the Eastern Conference? Any center in the Western Conference? Playoffs, watching all the way down. Championship ring.
He's got a good heart. Guy's got a good heart, there's no question about it. And he's a very, very giving person. There's a goodness about him that comes through.
It's a negative and positive reaction. Back up, the building is going to blow.
That's sort of my personality, to make everybody at ease. Just all around nice guy. Sorry. Sorry for being nice.
Yeah. Yeah, he right here, Flash right here. Hold on, Flash.
What up? What up? Hold on, hold on.
Hello. Yeah. Oh, yo, it worked for real, man.
Shaq, what would you say to those who say that at age 32, perhaps your best years are behind you?
Of course I'm old, but this is another classic Shaquille O'Neal quote. I'm like toilet paper, toothpaste, and certain amenities. I'm proven to be good and useful. So yes, I'm 32 and I'm getting older, but I still got 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10 more years left.
I like being different. And I strive on being the first to do stuff and the best to do it. That's what makes me like no other. A lot of people say so many guys do this, so many guys do that. I don't do those things. I do what I was taught, and I do the right thing. That's why I'm me, Shaquille O'Neal, like no other.
Let's go now to David Stern for the first selection of 1992.
With the first pick in the 1992 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic selects Shaquille O'Neal from Louisiana State University.
7'1", 300 pounds, only 20 years old.
Well, big smiles right now in Orlando, to say the least.
Even before setting foot on an NBA court, Shaq had earned the respect of the game's legends.
I think the best player in the world right now is probably Shaquille O'Neal, other than Michael Jordan, of course. Yeah. But I think once he gets in the league and gets established, he's going to be the same type of player. He won't be as flashy, but he's right up there with the best of all of them right now.
When I heard that, I was really amazed, because here's a guy who was already at that time a Hall of Famer before he even got done playing. And I didn't even think he knew who I was. So when I saw that on TV, I was like, wow, these guys know who I am? So now that they know who I am, I gotta come in and I gotta represent.
And Shaq wasted no time living up to his billing. Dominating from the start, he would become an instant sensation.
The Shaq went to the rack, and he took everybody with him.
O'Neal.
Oh, boy. Oh.
He's the guy, the new kid on the block. I mean, it's like when Magic came in, and then when Jordan came in, and now Shaquille. He's gonna be great for the league.
And even Shaquille was impressed with that one. Oh.
Transition.
Oh, what a dunk. Hey, look at him look back at Mourning.
Well, he's a very amazing talent, and I think he's the future of the NBA.
they picked a guy who they thought was going to help them win games. I don't think they knew how exciting I was going to be.
O'Neal! The Shaq is putting on a show.
I don't think they knew how generous I was going to be in the community. I don't think they knew how fun I was going to be.
Shaq would quickly take his place among the NBA's elite. He was named the starting center in the All-Star game, as well as the league's Rookie of the Year. And he would soon team up with another young star.
Second year, got Penny Hardaway. I was thinking the whole Magic Johnson Kareem thing because I am a student of the game.
In 1994, Shaq and Penny led the Magic to their first playoff berth. And the next year, they toppled Michael Jordan and the Bulls on their way to the finals. In just his third season, Shaq would play for the title.
The Orlando Magic. Welcome to the 1995 NBA Finals.
Take the sting out of my game, Shaq!
Woo! The 32-year-old Olajuwon is the NBA's best player. His team, its defending champion. O'Neal and the Magic test themselves against those standards.
Smith circles out back instead to give it to Drexler.
Oh,
Drexler driving. He goes. He puts it up. On the rim off. The Houston Rockets have stunned the Orlando Magic.
Houston went on to a sweep, humbling Shaq and the young Magic. The next season, Orlando took a step back on the playoff ladder. They were swept again, this time by the Bulls in the conference finals. After another disappointing finish, Shaq became a free agent. In the summer of 1996, the league's most celebrated center took his show to Hollywood, signing with the Los Angeles Lakers.
I was familiar with L.A. because I had the opportunity to go out to L.A. and do movies and do albums and do commercials, and L.A. made me an offer I couldn't refuse.
I can't tell you how excited Southern California is today. The Los Angeles Lakers have acquired a 24-year-old superstar who we feel is going to bring us to that incredible level that this franchise has enjoyed in Los Angeles.
The Lakers hadn't won an NBA title since the Showtime era in 1988. And now they look to their newest big man to restore their glorious tradition.
With Abdul-Jabbar and Will Chamberlain, we won a championship here. And with Shaquille O'Neal, we're going to win another championship.
Shaq seemed ready for his role as the next great Lakers center. And he would bring his own kind of showmanship to L.A. Yet even with their new superstar, the Lakers would continue to fall short in the postseason. They couldn't get past the reigning powers in the Western Conference, the Utah Jazz.
Picked up by Carl Malone, to Stockton, Malone, hammered up, Stockton to Malone.
And the Utah Jazz going to the Western Conference Finals.
Before you succeed, you must learn how to fail. I just hope that I don't have to, fail too many more times.
The sweep is complete. The Western King still reigns. The Utah Jazz are returning to the NBA Finals.
You know, our team for years couldn't quite figure out, how to get over that hump in the playoffs in terms of winning a championship.
As the man expected to deliver the title, it was Shaq who shouldered much of the blame. And the criticism grew louder after yet another playoff sweep. This time, at the hands of the Spurs.
And the San Antonio Spurs have swept aside the Los Angeles Lakers in the Western Conference semifinals. And they did it convincingly.
For Shaq, it only added to a painful history of playoff failures.
People continued to question, whether or not he could take us there. It was really eating him up inside himself.
After 7 years without a championship, Shaq had arrived at the crossroads of his career. And he realized that his legacy was on the line.
Now it's starting to get on me a little bit. Shaq's a great player, but he hasn't won. And now I'm starting to hear the buts.
I want to get to a level where Magic Johnson's at, where Will Chamberlain's at. That's the level that I'm trying to get at. I'm trying to win. Because, you know, right now they say, oh, Shaq can do this, he can do that, but he hasn't won a championship yet.
So that's basically the most important thing to you right now is winning a championship.
I have 10 fingers and no rings, and I love jewelry.
Without further ado, the new coach of the Los Angeles Lakers, Phil Jackson.
I called Phil. I was doing something in Montana. So I go to his house, his log cabin house.
I think I came home and he was already at my place and there was like 100 people lining the shore looking at him, entertaining him.
Before we did anything, it was a big log stuck on this thing. So me, him, Uncle Jerome and his son, we had to take the log and swim it out to an island.
It was already waterlogged, but then when Shaq got on it, it was submerged.
See, a negative person be like, I'm not jumping in that cold water. But see, I knew it was a test because, see, I already knew about Phil. I did my research. So I took all my clothes, jumped, swam, froze, came in. He brought me in this little den. And he had his house built in a way that he had a little roof and a light was coming in. And the light was hitting them gold balls and it was hitting me in the eye and I just felt like I was in a, you know, I just felt like I was in basketball heaven.
You know, when I came here, I wanted Shaq to, you know, get serious about an MVP trophy. I said that is something that should have his name etched on it.
No messing around. We're not doing nothing. We just want you to dominate. I need you to be MVP this season.
And Shaq embraced the challenge. After working hard on his game, he had become a more complete player than ever.
Inside Shaq, he's just too strong. Unbelievable display at 350 on a phenomenal finish.
Screen by Shaq, Green behind it. 19-footer on the way now.
When somebody gives you that responsibility of you know, putting it in your hands, it has to be done right.
How good has Shaquille O'Neal been this year? This man is possessed.
Phil showed me the way, not physically, but mentally. I had what it took physically to get there, but mentally I just needed someone to help me get to the next level.
Shaq and the Lakers were steamrolling through the league as they headed to the All-Star break.
Cannot play better than this.
You know, whenever I go to All-Star games, I just like to have fun. Never really go into it and say, hey, I'm gonna get the MVP. But that particular game, nobody was really getting off. You know, I'm a showman. I like to show off.
Oh, yeah.
The dish to Shaq, look out below.
And like, I look over at my family, you know, my boy Andre, Uncle Jerome, and say, get it, get the MVP. So, you know, I buckle down. You know, got a couple highlights, did this and did that. You know, Tim Duncan was having a great game too. Oh! You know, could have went either way that day, but they were gracious enough to split it.
Who gets to take the trophy home?
He got one of those rings, so I'm taking this.
As Shaq led the Lakers to the best record in the NBA, an even greater honor was still to come. And this time, he stood alone.
The best player in the league this year.
It's a pleasure to watch you grow. Congratulations, 1999-2000 NBA MVP Shaquille O'Neal.
For all my friends in the media who like quotes, mark this quote down. From this day on, I would like to be known as the Big Aristotle. Because it was Aristotle who said, excellence is not a singular act, but a habit. You are what you repeatedly do.
He had proven his individual greatness. Now it was time to show he could lead his team to a championship.
We got all the pieces now, buddy. You got Kobe, you got Shaq, you got all these good role players, and you got Phil. There ain't no excuses now. If you can't get it done now, you're gonna have butts behind your name for the rest of your life.
As the playoffs began, Shaq was on a mission, leading LA past the Kings. Next up were the Phoenix Suns, but they were simply no match for Shaquille.
And the LA Lakers went big as they routed the Phoenix Suns.
But an arch rival was standing in their path.
Western Conference Finals, the team that we had trouble with, Portland Trail Blazers.
Shaq and the Lakers would go up 3-1, but then began to lose control of the series as Portland battled back. And after 67 regular season wins, LA still needed one more.
There will be a game 7. Staples Center, here we come.
It's a 1-game showdown. Winner, take all.
They're not happy with their performance, that's for sure. But I think they understand that this is a war, and this battle tonight was lost, but the war is not over.
Game 7. The Western Conference Championship on the line. The series is tied at 3-3. And this afternoon, it's put up or shut up.
And it would be the Trailblazers who put up the best performance for most of the game. They took a huge lead into the fourth quarter. And the ghosts of past playoff failures were haunting the Lakers once again.
Now Smitty has it. 10 to shoot. A long three is in! Smitty with a dagger right through the eyes.
The Trailblazers have blown it open. The Staples Center is sitting in stunned silence.
The threat of being a loser, you know, being out of the playoffs, and once again facing the disappointment, that was something that no one obviously wanted to deal with, but for that moment was right there before you.
This is a 15-point game.
I'm sitting over on the bench, and I'm trying to figure out, you know, what just happened and how all of a sudden that we find ourselves in a position where, you know, this could be over for us.
The Lakers are at their mercy right now. They totally collapse.
Shaq doesn't do it. Everything he's accomplished this year goes up in smoke.
But there was still one quarter left for Shaq and the Lakers to save their season.
We still were puzzled. Okay, how are we going to get this done? We know we can do it, but how are we going to do it?
They would rely on the same ingredients that had carried them all year. The dominance and determination of their leader, who refused to let them lose.
When you have Shaquille O'Neal making plays like that, that inspires the rest of the guys.
Those guys that started that fourth quarter, their defensive intensity went up to a level that was off the charts, and they started making life miserable for the Blazers. You know, there was possession after possession. I mean, they couldn't even get a shot at the basket, and guys on our team were making big shots and making big plays.
Shot blocked by Bryant, and Kobe controls in the corner. All of a sudden, the Blazers can't buy a hoop.
The whole season on the line.
You have to take good shots from now on.
There's a big trip for the Lakers. Horry comes left to Fox, a left corner three by Shaw. Good! Bryant Shaw right down the well.
Great rally by the Lakers.
You can see the confidence and the confidence just rise with the Lakers.
Once the cavalry started to charge, I remember a sense that there was nothing going to stop the momentum.
O'Neal has it right in the lane. The jump hook, back it in. The Lakers have taken the lead.
From 15 points down to knock it down to 13, 11, 9, 2, all the way back to this incredible comeback was one of the most amazing things you've ever seen.
And fittingly, it was Shaq who would cap off the Lakers' historic comeback in one unforgettable moment.
Kobe's going to the basket, and I'm on the bench, and I'm jumping up and down, and I'm like, oh, there's Shaq, don't you, Shaq.
Kobe on the move, lobs for O'Neal. Kobe Bryant worked into the lane, and Shaq hammered it in with a right hand.
That might have been the highest that, you know, Shaq's ever jumped.
And I just went up. And I just got it, and I rammed it through. That was the backbreaker.
Parker can put the champagne away and get out the bottled water.
That was probably the single greatest moment in Los Angeles sports history.
And at that time, I had my first son, little Sharif. A lot of people see me running and pointing up. At that time, my Shawnee and my son, they were sitting in the suite. So I was just pointing up to him, letting him know that, hey, your daddy is Superman. After the emotional Portland game, I go down to my theater, and I got the 94-95 finals. And I watched all four games, watching how I played and how I looked, and then watching the after effects.
The Houston Rockets have swept the Orlando Magic.
So now, as I'm watching the game, I'm just taking my head off, and I'm just throwing anger in there. just taking up old articles. Shaq ain't nothing, he'll never win. I remember what everybody said. Shaq can't do that, Shaq can't do it. I remembered all that, and I got it in my head.
He would carry those memories into the 2000 NBA Finals against Indiana. And as the series began, it seemed that he was taking out all his frustrations on the Pacers.
Shaq, yeah, take that.
Rick kept saying to me, Rick Fox kept saying, they're not doubling Shaq. And I kept saying, good, and stop mentioning it before they hear you. And they saw why you should always send three and four people after him.
Shaq is in, slams it for 43 on the alley-oop pass.
He's got one thing in his mind, winning a championship. I've never seen him better.
His ability to overpower people at that time was unmatched, maybe in NBA history, maybe greater than Wilt's. And Indiana had the misfortune of catching Shaq at the transcendent height of his career.
These guys were trying their best, and there wasn't anything that they could do. He physically dominated the game on both ends. He blocked shots, he rebounded. He scored almost at will.
A lot of teams have come up with strategies in defending against you, and none of them have worked. How would you defend against yourself?
I wouldn't. I would just go home. I would fake an injury or something.
But the Pacers never did find any answers, and it was clear that the series and the season belonged to Shaq.
Shaq has just dominated.
It's like a man against boys here tonight.
The MVP, the look in his face, the man wants a championship to finish this season.
He did everything to lead our team to the championship that year, everything.
Kobe in deep, give to Shaq. Shaq is hammered, scores, foul. Listen to this crowd, the Lakers have the lead.
The first NBA championship.
Shaq, not only the MVP of the regular season, but also the playoffs. Look at the tears running down his cheek.
Congratulations to the NBA 2000 champion, Los Angeles Lakers, their fans, and the city.
I just want to say thank y'all for believing in us. We're going to get one next year, too. My teammates, I love y'all.
Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here.
Yeah, get a look at the dynasty. This is the next one right here.
Diesel. Finally got one. Yeah. Finally got one.
So now that I got one, I got the monkeys off my back. Playing the Staples Center every day, you look up, you see them jerseys. Like, damn, I want to be up there one day. See, those guys had many championships. So if I wanted to get the same amount of respect that they had, I got to do what they do.
Shaq was now seeking his place in history. And as the 2001 season began, he would pursue his goal with a vengeance. He wanted back-to-back titles, and the rest of the team shared his single-minded determination.
Now, when you're a champion, you know you always want to repeat. We had the blueprint, we knew what we had to do. And that year was so fun that we wanted to do it again, so we would talk about it all the time.
Once again, Shaquille led the Lakers on a march through the postseason, and this time, they would make it look easy. L.A. swept all three of their Western Conference opponents on their way back to the NBA Finals.
Down, down, down! There's no team in Laker history ever played at a higher level of perfection than this team is doing.
And the finals that year were interesting because Shaq went against the best center he was going to go against in a final series of his era. Dikembe Mutombo is one of the great all-time defensive centers and was one of the last, you know, guys to really be able to stand up to Shaq.
But O'Neal turning and slamming it with a right hand.
When you play against a shot blocker, you got to take it right here. You can't beat him up there because he'll get it. You got to take it right there. And what I did to Dikembe, oldest trick in the book, bump, bump, booyah. Bump, bump, bang. See, get him off balance. See, he was a lightweight. and I would bump him to get him rocking back and get him rocking back, and then I'd take it right there. And he couldn't do nothing. It was too late. And then he was the guy that, hey, I can play him and didn't want to double. And he said that in the media. Hey, I'm defensive player of the year. Shaq ain't going to do that to me.
Rebound down to O'Neal. O'Neal going up, and he slams it home. Wow, Shaquille O'Neal with a ferocious right-hand jam.
He was as physically dominant in the finals in 2001 as he was in 2000. He dominated Dikembe Mutombo and Ty McCullough and Matt Geiger and all these guys that Philadelphia kept throwing at him.
Up off the rim. Oh, man, what a dunk by O'Neal. Shaquille O'Neal with a two-hand rebound slam.
With a five-game victory over Philadelphia, the mission was complete. Shaq had staked his claim to history.
Back-to-back titles for the Los Angeles Lakers.
I love you.
You had the best record ever in the history of the NBA playoffs. You should be proud of that.
Yeah.
Went through that finals. Now we had two. I'm like, damn, I'm the man. I got two.
I told you I was going to get another one.
And we're going to get another one next year.
The big I told you so.
Behind their big man, the Lakers had returned to the top of the NBA. The challenge now was to become one of the greatest teams of all time. In 2002, Shaq would try to turn dominance into a dynasty. He led his team back to the finals, this time against the New Jersey Nets, who were simply overmatched.
What do you do with the big fella, Chip?
Nothing you can do with him.
What can I say, guys? Too much Shaquille O'Neal. You know, he's a monster. That's all I can say about him.
A three-peat and a sweep for the world champion Los Angeles Lakers.
Shaquille O'Neal, no question, the most valuable player on this series, becoming the third player to win the NBA Finals MVP award three times, only the second player to win it three consecutive times, the other, Michael Jordan.
There can only be one champion, and we have a worthy one, the Los Angeles Lakers. They are a team for the ages.
What happened with Magic in the 80s was not a one-time phenomenon. Shaq was the extension of Laker greatness. He was the continuation of the dynasty.
That's right. They going for 10.
What did I say last year at the parade? I'm gonna give you a few seconds to go back and look.
I got up here last year and said we was gonna do it again. I'm saying it again. We're gonna three-peat. Can you dig it?
Told you. Number three. I'm gonna be trying to get four. Love ya. Check it.
And after three straight championships and three finals MVP trophies and one regular season MVP trophy, he was well on his way to having the legacy that he wanted.
And title number four seemed within reach until the Lakers' playoff magic finally ran out.
Bowen, here's Horry for three! Robinson on the rebound, that was in and out!
And if not for one Robert Horry shot that goes, it looked like halfway into the basket in San Antonio before it somehow pops out again. You know, maybe they win a fourth championship.
So before the 2004 season, LA acquired future Hall of Famers Karl Malone and Gary Payton in an effort to regain the title.
Shaq was pushing it the whole way. These are two guys who are among his favorites. And he's saying, you know, Karl, come play for me. Come get your ring that you deserve. Gary, come play with me. Come get the ring you deserve.
As the season began, it seemed that the plan was falling into place.
Here come the Lakers. Two on one, three on one.
So much focus on, you know, possibly the greatest four basketball players together on one team ever, that we never really found an identity outside of those four guys as a team that entire year.
The Lakers still made it back to the finals, where they faced the underdog Detroit Pistons. But Detroit would use its teamwork to overcome LA star power, and they stunned the Lakers in five games.
is this an end of an era for you guys with the Lakers, and do you see yourself playing for a different team in the future?
This summer is going to be a different summer for a lot of people, and everyone's going to, you know, take care of their own business, and everyone is going to do what's best for them, including me.
Kobe left elbow, lost the handle, picked up by Rip. Rip for the drive, by himself, a throwdown, he tomahawked it.
Following their defeat, the Lakers decided not to retain Phil Jackson, Shaq's mentor. And with the team heading in a different direction, it was clear that his time in LA was coming to an end.
Quickly, after the finals, it all collapsed around Shaq. And the next thing he knew, he was in South Beach.
The major headline around the league tonight focuses on the situation down in Miami. The Los Angeles Lakers and Miami Heat have agreed to a trade that will send Shaquille O'Neal, one of the greatest big men of all time, to sunny South Florida.
It may be the most significant NBA trade in history. Will Chamberlain got traded, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar got traded. Why not Shaq? Pat Riley got his man.
Everyone knows I'm a tropical man. So if it ain't tropical, I'm not there.
At that particular time, it was the biggest thing that happened in South Florida probably since the Dolphins went 17-0.
You know, this is a football town, but it seems like all anyone's been talking about is Shaq and the Heat, and the excitement is snowballing.
The day that Shaq came down, the day he had his parade in the city, I've never been the same. And now Miami is known more than just its warm weather.
There was a buzz and energy in the city, and everybody just got excited about Heat basketball again.
I don't think I've ever seen anything like it. The guy's larger than life. I read somewhere where someone said, he's made us important again. He's made basketball in Miami important again.
Like I said, man, before I came to this town, man, this town was nothing, man. But now that I'm here, all right, thank you.
I've been with the Heat from the very beginning in 1988, and there has never been a time like this.
Actually, when I was rolling up, I was telling my wife I felt like the president. Dun, 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 dun. Hello, Miami. I said hello, Miami.
He becomes an icon, a cult figure, all in one, far, far greater than anybody else the city has ever seen.
The reception I got in Miami was very beautiful, very overwhelming. I guess they felt when I signed here that they got a guy that could take him to the next level, a guy that was going to heighten the exposure of the town, of the team. It's been great. People here have been very hospitable, and it's just a lovely town to be in.
Shaq, when you think about ticket sales, the jersey, you've got nightclubs setting aside tables for you, chefs ready to make your favorite dish, getting keys to the city. When you think about your impact on this area, how would you characterize it?
That has nothing to do with basketball. That's just because I'm sexy. No, it's fun. I'm glad that I'm welcome by the city, and it's going to be a great time here.
When he came here, he said, look it, you haven't won yet. So I want you to win. I want the Heat to win. I want the city to experience a world championship, and I think he's truly committed to that.
Remember this, I'm going to bring a championship to Miami, I promise.
With a new beginning in Miami, Shaq would quickly live up to all the anticipation, reminding everyone that he was still an overpowering force.
Blocked by O'Neal, his third block of the game. That was big. Wade on the drive, put it in the air. Shaq slammed it through. He's everywhere. The big man has come with everything today. Oh! Oh, my!
Bring in the big fella right back. Oh, man.
Daddy's home, and he's hungry.
This guy is so strong, it's unbelievable.
This is a dream come true. You know, we've got the best, most dominating center in the league.
Inside Shaq, he's just too strong. Bodies are flying right and left.
He's showing why he's the most dominant big fella in the game today.
What he brought to the court side of it was a tremendous amount of confidence. Put confidence in his teammates that now we got somebody that we could really go out there and go to war with. And after a 10-6 start, the team won 12 in a row, and they were off to the races for the rest of the year.
And here comes Miami. 3-on-2 break. Wade for Jones. Shaq on the finish. The Heat do it again. The win streak lives on for a 28th night in a row.
But Shaq wasn't lifting the Heat by himself. he joined young star Dwayne Wade to form the league's most dynamic new duo.
We clicked right away. The first game of the season against New Jersey, my first dime to Shaq was off one of my crossovers, and I threw it back to him. He dunked it, and with a foul.
Wade curls it for Shaq, a slam and a foul.
And that was like, that's the first one, and there's many more to come.
Wade runs Kobe around his screen, running floater, alley-oop by Shaq. Right side of the basket for the two-handed flush. It's been a great 1-2 inside-outside punch for Miami. What a play. Dwayne Wade put it in the sky. Shaquille O'Neal crashed in the dunk. Backdoor. Wade, look out below. That is picture perfect.
I think one of the great things that happened to him when he came here was Dwayne Wade being younger and also very aware of Shaquille's success. He respected him, showed him great respect and respect of his position and where his standing is in the league.
Me and Shaquille O'Neal is still like a dream come true to me to be playing one of the most dominant players to play the game.
Wade, Shaquille O'Neal.
Wade on the drive, out to O'Neal, the rim cleared. He almost ripped the rim down. It is swagger time here in Chicago.
Everything happened for a reason. I got there with a new young team, sat down with Dwayne Wade, my last and final pupil, and I told him the problems I had with my first pupil, told him the problems I had with my second pupil. And I said, I'm telling you this because we can't have these problems. If we want to get it done and win, we can't have this problem. And me being the type of real person that I am, you learn from your mistakes. And we have a great relationship. We can talk to each other any kind of way, and don't take it personal. And we're actually best friends.
With Miami leading the Eastern Conference, they seemed poised for a title run. But then, adversity would strike late in the regular season.
Shaq is going to the locker room and gimping a little bit. He is gone for the night.
I got the freak injury. Jermaine O'Neal kneed me in the thigh, and I had a very bad thigh bruise.
Shaq had to miss the final two regular season games, but he battled through the pain and took to the court against the Heat's first round playoff opponents, the New Jersey Nets. Though Shaq was hobbled, Miami swept the Nets in four straight, and their drive for a championship seemed on track.
Win another title, all right?
The thigh injury forced him back to the sidelines in the next round against Washington. But Dwayne Wade carried the Heat to another sweep, and their playoff express rolled on.
For the first time since 1997, the Miami Heat have made it to the Eastern Conference Finals.
In his first year in Miami, Shaq and his bruised body had carried the Heat as far as they'd ever been before. But in their way were the reigning champion Pistons. A hobbled Shaq would return to play valiantly against Detroit.
What a start for Shaquille O'Neal.
But the Heat would suffer yet another blow when his wingman Dwayne Wade went down with a rib injury.
Down to the floor is Dwayne Wade. He's a little slow getting up.
Despite their injuries, Dwayne and Shaq kept the Heat in the series.
Wade the alley-oop. And a two-hand monster jam by O'Neal.
Everyone knows in the playoffs, the time where I like to raise my game. Wasn't able to raise my game, and still we almost got it done.
But in the end, they would fall to the chance in the closing moments of a decisive Game 7.
I think if I was 100%, then we would have made it. But freak injury stood in my way. So this summer I had to go back into the lab, and here I am again.
Though Miami added some new faces for 2006, Shaq remained the cornerstone. And in his second year with the Heat, he has transformed them into championship contenders.
Shaq always said, Zoe, you built this, but I came in and refurbished it.
But for Shaq, the job won't be complete until he brings a championship to Miami.
When I didn't have any, I wanted one. When I got one, I wanted two. When I got two, I wanted three. So now that I have three, of course I want four.
He come in every day and work because he want to win another championship. You know, he wanted to go out on top. And, you know, if I can be a part of helping him get there, I mean, I think that'll be something that one of my biggest accomplishments in life.
The best part about being Shaquille O'Neal is that I'm the luckiest guy in the world.
It has been a remarkable career for Shaquille O'Neal, and he has left a lasting impression on everyone he's met along the way.
I love being around him. He's a good guy, and he makes me feel good. He makes everybody feel good.
Where's Mama?
Hola.
Hello, Mama.
Alberto. Nice. I love you.
Shaq's personality will go to the top of the list of, you know, when everybody starts remembering all the great things that he did on the court and how great he was. He's a great human being. He has as big a heart as he is.
Go get something to eat, homeboy. All right, brother, you stay up. All right, go get something to eat. I'll take care. All right, I'm gonna see you again.
I can't remember a day as a teammate of his where I didn't have fun going to work.
He has an incredible sense of humor and has this extreme comic relief about him that a lot of people just don't know. You get more of a sense of that when you're around him. But when he steps on the court, he's all business. He's about winning. He's proven that. He's a proven winner.
My motivation is one word, legacy. It has nothing to do with money, nothing to do with fame, none of it. It's a legacy. I'm very selfish when it comes to the legacy of Shaquille O'Neal.
O'Neal, that is power personified.
When I'm done playing, and I open the book and look at me, I would like to say Shaq, like no other, 4 or 5 championships. That's what I wanted to say. Now, if I could see that, then I can go.
Give me the famous smile. Yeah.
When I'm talking to my sons, I'm gonna say, look, your daddy was a bad, shut your mouth. I wanna show them, hey, daddy had 4, 5, or 6. They talk about Mike and they talk about Magic, but your daddy up there too, buddy.
10, 20, 30 years from now, when we look back on the scope and the breadth of Shaq's career, I believe that as a combination of size, power, speed, and athleticism, he'll be looked on as the single most unstoppable force in modern NBA basketball. Right there with Wilt, and definitely better than everybody else.
With the way Magic and Larry Bird transcended the game of basketball in the 80s and then Michael in the 90s, I think Shaq deserves the credit for continuing the league past Michael into this new millennium. You can't get into that room over there. That's only like reserved for certain people, and I think Shaq has to kind of move into that category now.
The best player in the NBA, no question about it.
I don't think there'll ever be another basketball player like Shaquille O'Neal, ever.
There's no doubt that his legacy is already formed and shaped. He wants to be considered the most dominant big man ever in the history of the game.
He's everywhere. The big man has come with everything today.
He will definitely have left footprints, you know, massive ones, you know, in the sand for other people to follow.
What really excites me about my retirement is that I'm going to be the best daddy in the world.
Show him your form 10 times. The form, your shot, show him that shot. Leave it up there, leave it up there. Go. One. Ah, you see how pretty?
I'm their friend first, then their daddy, rather than daddy and no friend. And so when I'm done playing, I'm gonna be there and it's just gonna be fun. And I get to watch them grow.
Ah, now leave the last one like it's going all the way through there.
They don't ever have to play basketball. I won't be mad if they don't play basketball. But they will have to be somebody. And they will have to respect their elders and respect each other.
Say bye, Daddy.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye, Daddy.
Big head boo-boo.
Yeah.
Me? That's you, that's big head boo-boo.
Here you have it, a juvenile delinquent from Newark, New Jersey. He was told numerous times, you had ADD. you're dumb. You ain't gonna be nothing. And I didn't believe him. I listened to one person, me. And here I am, Shaquille O'Neal, like no other.
You know, a lot of people always ask me, what do I want to do in my career? I've done so much. The answer is I want to do more. So if I've done much and I want to do more, I need to do much more.
Listen to this quote. Winston Churchill said, shine the light on those being led, not the leader. Remember that one, Winston Churchill.
I just want to say I love you, Brian Shaw. May I kiss you, Brian Shaw?
Whatever you thinketh will becometh. Remember that, little kids. Whatever you thinketh, it will becometh.
Can you dig it?
Shaq, word association game. Car, Mercedes, comic book character, Superman. What animal do you think you resemble on the court?
Ask my wife that.
First I hit him with a little Aristotle, now I'm hit him with a little Socrates, a little Shakespeare.
It's hard being an NBA sexable, but somebody has to do it.
From now on, I am no longer the big Aristotle. I want to be known as the big Shakespeare.
Are we to assume that you're going to rededicate yourself and become the leaner, meaner Diesel you were back in Orlando?
That would be correct, young man.
He's an all-around nice guy.
That would be 1,000% correct, buddy. Tough guy. You want a piece of me?
Sorry for being nice.